The same songs with the same old rhymes. Tell me to shake it off and swing. I have to teach online.
Welcome to online at home learning. My name is Connor Welch. I'm a STEM Rec AC. Many of you should know me, but if you don't recognize me, it may be because you have your STEM Rec in the afternoon. I teach in the morning. I'm excited to share with you a lesson on perspective and the scale of the universe. So what size are you? Where do you fit in? And how big really does our universe get? So this lesson is going to focus on the bigger picture, and then maybe next lesson we'll go smaller. We'll zoom in. But right now we're going to zoom out, and we're going to look at how big we are compared to the universe, or maybe better said, how small we really are. So let's dive on in. Okay, so you can see that this application shows a little human. Okay, this human's going to represent you. Okay, you as a child are probably maybe 3 or 4, maybe even 5 feet tall. And so we can see that here is our reference point, our scale. And so we can see that this is a meter long. This is about 3 feet long. But let's just zoom in a little bit. Either way, let's see. Let's just zoom in and we see this inch ruler. We all know how long a ruler is, right? It's about 12 inches, or it is exactly 12 inches, and it's about maybe this long, right? And yeah, we are about 3 or 4 of these tall. Okay, so here's our reference point right now. Okay, let's zoom out. We're gonna go farther out so you can see that as I zoom out, that ruler is going to get smaller and smaller, meaning we're zooming out. We're going to get things smaller and smaller. We're going to start looking at bigger things. So here you are as a human. Okay. And here's a beach volleyball. So it's about the size of your hip. It goes up to your hip. So there we go. We're about on the foot length. So we're going to keep zooming out. We're going to look at bigger and bigger things. So some things we can note are elephants and giraffes and T-Rexes. We know of those sizes. We know they're really, really big. And we know that when we're next to them, we're a little bit smaller. So how big does our universe actually get? Well, we're going to go all the way. We're going to keep zooming out until we are at the point where we can look at the entire universe. Or at least we can use this application on the internet to see kind of the scale of the universe. So let's keep going. Okay, so here's the Apollo Lunar Module. It can fit maybe 4 or 5 people in it. I think there was that many people in the actual Apollo mission. And still right here, there's you. You're pretty small compared to that little lunar module. This is the module that landed on the moon with Neil Armstrong. Okay, let's keep going. Okay, so we can see a long neck dinosaur. Very, very big. Look how small you are. You're almost not even visible when we're looking at the dinosaur. Let's keep going, though. Okay, a blue whale. That's the largest mammal living on this Earth today. Okay, I'm going to go look at this Boeing 747. So if anybody's ever ridden on a plane, you know they are very, very big. This is one of the bigger ones. So let's go look at a picture of that. Okay, so we see this plane is huge. Look how many little windows there are in that. Look how big that is. And your head would just barely fit out that window. So you are very small right now, okay? Let's keep going though. Alright, we keep zooming out, and we see the Eiffel Tower. Maybe some people have visited that in Paris. And we see the Great Pyramids of Giza. Okay, so let's look at the Great Pyramids of Giza. They're really big. These guys are actually closer on the camera, so they look bigger, but in actuality, they may be about that big. Maybe one of those little stones, right? So huge, huge pile. It was the biggest man-made structure until we started doing skyscrapers and things like that. till recently. So we're going to keep going. Okay. We're starting to see now large land masses like waterfalls, really big waterfalls. Let's keep going. Okay, so this is an asteroid. This is a very large asteroid. This could have been about the size of the asteroid that hit the Earth and caused the mass extinction of the dinosaurs. Okay, and here's Mount Everest. Let's go explore Mount Everest and see how big that is. Okay. Okay, so I have the volume muted, but here is that mountain. Look at that. That is massive, massive. Okay, so there it is in the distance. And you can see, let's pause that. Look how high up they are. They are very high up, and we are, on this scale, very, very small. Okay, so let's keep going. We're going to zoom out even further. Okay, there's Halley's Comet. Just for a reminder and maybe to learn about this, is a comet is an icy structure. You have an asteroid, which is more of a rocky structure, and you have a comet. This is more icy. Okay, let's keep going. So if you don't recognize a lot of these things, that's okay. We're going to start exploring really, really big objects. So just bear with me, and we're going to look at just certain objects so we can kind of get a sense of how small we are. Keep in mind, you're in this little circle. You're very, very small. We can't even see you right now, okay? Okay, let's keep going. Okay, so there's Italy. Maybe some of you have heard on the news the issues going on right there, but we're not going to focus on that. We're going to keep going out. We're going to keep going. There's Texas. All right, and there's Pluto. So that was once a planet, but it was just too small. It didn't fill the three categories of being considered a planet. So now it is considered a dwarf planet. And so we're going to keep going. Keep going. Okay, so we're really, really small. Keep in mind, look. Here's the Earth. You're somewhere right over here in Utah. But we can't even see you. It's so zoomed out. We're so far out that we can't even see you. Okay, let's keep going. All right. There's Neptune. Okay, so Saturn is the sixth planet from the sun. It is notable for its very large ring structures. Let's just go look at that for a second. All right, here's Saturn. Very, very big gaseous planet. And if we put you on this little map, on this little image, we wouldn't even see you. You would not even be a speck. Now keep in mind, as we zoom out more and more, it's okay to be small. It may humble you a little bit. It might put it in perspective. And it might help you realize that maybe a little mistake you made today isn't actually that important. Okay, so here's the distance from the Earth to the Moon. Okay, so that it looks like from going to the Earth to the Moon, when we use that Apollo lunar module, we had to travel the length of a Saturn. Okay, so that's that. Okay, these little red dots right here, these are stars. Okay, so we have the Sun. That's our star for our solar system, but there's many, there's billions of trillions of stars. And so a star is anything that can emit energy through a nuclear process. We won't get into too much, but they actually will radiate light. They will send out light. So let's see where ours is. Okay, the Sun. Okay, so you can see that it looks very similar to this star, a little bit different to this star, but the Sun isn't that unique. Isn't that interesting? Our Sun, when the one we see up in the sky, isn't that unique. So let's keep going. But it's very, very big. Actually, that reminds me. Let's go look at the Sun. Look how interesting this is. So this is from NASA. This is a high definition footage of the Sun. Now don't look at the Sun just directly. We're going to look at it through a camera right here. This is actually, I believe, an infrared or an ultraviolet light shot. So we wouldn't be able to even see this with our eyes, but high-tech cameras can, and we can see how beautiful that is. That's all this energy and radiation given off. Look at that. So if we put you in here, you would be so small, you'd be a little dot. Look at that. Kind of looks like a volcano. But that's a lot of energy being released right there. Okay, here's a different shot, maybe a different wavelength of sorts, but we're going to pause that and we're going to keep going. So right now we're at the sun. We all know the sun in the sky looks pretty small. It looks the size of the moon, but it's not. Well, if we go back, let's go try to find the moon again. The moon, oh, let's see. Oh, here's the moon. The moon is much, much smaller. Look at that. Zoom, zoom, zoom. You could fit a lot of moons in the sun. Look at that. It's just a little pebble. So imagine how small you are, because you know how big the moon is. You can see that. Okay, let's keep going. Okay, so here, let's keep going. I remember that one. Let's go. Okay, this is an interesting little measurement. Total human height. That means if we stacked each other on top of one another's shoulders or heads, every single human, if we made a huge, really big tower, would be this length. It'd be bigger and longer than the sun. So that shows you how many people we have. Even though we're small in big numbers, we can have a big effect. Okay, let's keep going. Okay, so here's the distance from the Earth to the sun. Okay, if anybody's ran a mile, you know how hard that is. It takes a long time. A quick mile time is about 6 minutes. Imagine running about 100 million miles. So that's how big this is right here. This is 100 million miles. That's really long. That's a really big distance. Okay, let's keep going. Okay, so these are some really big stars. It kind of puts in perspective that our star is actually kind of small in comparison to some of the stars that are out there. Look at all those. Kind of pretty. Okay, here's the Kuiper Belt. The Kuiper Belt is pretty much the edge of our solar system, kind of. And it is a ring of just comets, little icy comets that hugs the solar system. And so this is where a comet would come from. So when you see a shooting star, it may be a little comet, like a Halley's Comet. It could also be space trash, which is interesting. So there's that. So hey, that's Cooper's Belt. So there's pretty much our solar system. I mean, it can go farther out, but those are like the actual objects that reach out. So here's the sun, and then maybe the Earth would be right about there, and we keep going out. Okay. All right, so this is the length. This is the distance the Voyager 1 has traveled from Earth. So here's Earth, and this is the distance the Voyager 1 has traveled. So the Voyager 1 is a man-made object, and it is the farthest man-made object. It has traveled the farthest distance. Let me reword that. It is the farthest traveled man-made object, and it's traveled very far. Let's see if I have... Oh no, I don't have that one. Okay, let's keep going. Okay, so now we're going to start seeing nebulas. All right, so we're past the star. A nebula is a cluster or a space of gas. Okay, so this is a lot of gas. These are little particles that are not solid. They're just floating around, kind of like air that we breathe in, but they're colorful. Let me think of a good example. You know, when you cook something hot and then the steam rises off of it, it's kind of that smoke, that steam that comes off of like your microwaved spaghetti or something like that. So this is a lot. This is a huge area, huge point of gas, okay? And it's mostly made from either two things. It's either made from an exploding sun, or it was already there and it's starting to now form new suns. So we can kind of watch this video. Let me see if I have it. Of the exploding sun. So this is not, I'm sorry, not this sun, an exploding star. So this is not our sun. There's only one sun. That's our star. That's our solar system star. Here are other stars that have exploded. Now, this might scare you a little bit, but keep in mind these are very, very far away from us and will not hurt us at all. Okay, so here's an erupting star. and it gives off all its mass, and now it's so powerful, so energetic, and so hot that it can't be a solid. It's just little gas particles. You see those? Okay, let's watch that one. So a lot of cool little graphic representations. Don't worry, there's no astronaut actually filming those in space. He would be toasted, or she would be toasted. This is actually just an animation, computer animation. Look at that. Boom. Okay, so that is a huge amount of just gas and particles and things like that. Okay, let's pause that for a second. So here's the first one, the Homunculus Nebula. Okay, let's keep going. Here's the light day. This is the length that light would travel in one day. So light travels really fast. Look at that. Okay, let's keep going. Okay, we're going to start seeing some really cool nebulas. Remember, nebulas are big, gaseous areas that probably originated from big stars exploding. Okay, let's keep going. Oh, I think I had a picture for the Stingray Nebula. Let me see. Here's the Stingray Nebula. Look at that. That's cool. So it almost looks like there's stars in the middle, but those are probably just in the way. The star that's in the middle has already erupted, and now it's exploding outward. Okay, let's keep going. Hourglass Nebula, that was just the animation that we just saw. Okay, let's keep going. We'll zoom in. There's the length of a light year. Okay. Ant Nebula, Rotten Egg Nebula. There's a lot of nebulas. Have your parents help you search different nebulas and explore them. They're really, really cool. So you can see how big they get. And just keep in mind, you're a little tiny. You're not even visible right now. You're so tiny right now. Look at that. We're going to keep zooming out, keep zooming out. Okay, here's a Omega Centauri. This is just a cluster of stars. Okay, so we're getting really far out. Let's see if we can start hitting some galaxies. Do you know what a galaxy is? A galaxy is a cluster of stars that are attracted to the center. The center is a black hole. And so all these little stars rotate around the black hole. So it's kind of like a really, really big solar system. So you have your solar system, which is an Earth with planets going around. Then you zoom out, you have your stars, and your stars, millions and millions of stars, are now orbiting a black hole. So we're going to start seeing really big structures here in a second. Let's see. Okay, let's see. Sagittarius, dwarf galaxy. So that's not quite a galaxy yet. There's not enough, I think there's not a big enough black hole for it to actually be considered a galaxy, so it's not really swarming it. Okay, so sombrero, look, kind of looks like a sombrero hat. Galaxy, these are big galaxies. Okay, so here's the Milky Way. What's important about the Milky Way? That's right, that's our galaxy. So we're on one of these little wings right here. Our star would be maybe right here. There's our star. Boop, let's see if it, oh, there we go. It's a little bright star, but actually kind of small. And then our solar system somewhere in there. So this is really, really big. Here is our neighbor galaxy. Okay, so here's our neighbor galaxy. Let me show you this. This is kind of cool. Okay, so here's our galaxy. Let me just show you. We're going to zoom in. Look at that. Those are billions and billions and billions of stars. Look at all those. So each one of those stars has a lot of little planets. Maybe we're just this star right there. That's our sun right there, okay, maybe. There's the Milky Way. Look at how beautiful that is. Billions and billions of stars. So yeah, we're on one of these little spiral arms. So we couldn't see this because we are in here, but this is just how we predict it to look. But we can see our neighbor. Here's a depiction. This is not real, but this is what the Andromeda galaxy does look like. It's just zoomed in because it's actually getting closer to us. Okay, let's keep going. All right, this is about the end of where we're gonna get, but look, see, we're still very far. Here's distance to the Andromeda galaxy, very far. So you know what, don't worry about it. You're not gonna get hurt by that galaxy. Okay, Here we go. Oh my goodness, we're so zoomed out, so zoomed out, so zoomed out. Okay, don't worry about all these little depictions. These are just crazy little pictures of just huge things that are pretty crazy. Okay, so here's the observable universe. So this would be 13.7 billion light years across. Okay, so this is huge. This is as big as it gets. All right, we can't see past this because the light that starts right here hasn't traveled to us quite yet. All right, so that's the biggest we've gotten so far. So thank you for joining me. I hope you had a good time. Let's just do a cool little zoom in and just remind ourselves how small we really are. Whoa. Wow. Oh no. If it's making you sick, look away. Oh, wow, wow. Look at all those things. We're coming in. Brace for a landing. Brace. There you are. And we're back. Welcome. Thanks again for joining. See you later.